Good morning, children. Welcome back to your biology class. How are you? I hope all of you are fine. Today, let's start our new chapter. Chapter number 10, Respiration in Organisms. Let me start today's session with a question. Why do we respire? Why do we respire? We know all living things' bodies made up of small and microscopic units called as cell, and each cell performs some functions like nutrition, excretion, transportation, etc. So for performing these functions, they require energy. Then why do we get energy? We get energy from food, isn't it? Food store energy, but this energy will only release in the process of respiration. So we need to respire to get energy. During breathing, we breathe in air, and you know that air contains oxygen. We also breathe out air, which is rich in carbon dioxide. So the air that we breathe in has to transport to all parts of our body, and ultimately it reaches into the cells. Inside the cells, the food is breathed down in the presence of this oxygen and release energy. And that process is called as cellular respiration. So what is cellular respiration? Cellular respiration is the process of breaking of food molecules in the presence of oxygen inside the cells. Children, cellular respiration takes place in the cells of all organisms. We can classify respiration into two types: aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Aerobic means in presence of oxygen. So in aerobic respiration, glucose means the smallest part, the smallest unit of the food molecule, that is glucose. So glucose will be break down to form carbon dioxide, water and energy. So this process only takes place in the presence of oxygen. That process is called as aerobic respiration. The second one is anaerobic respiration. So here oxygen is not required. So in the absence of oxygen, glucose will be break down to form carbon dioxide, alcohol and energy. Okay, so this type of anaerobic respiration is seen in yeast. You know, yeast are single-celled organisms. They respire anaerobically, and this process is also called as fermentation in the case of yeast. Okay, and this yield alcohol. So this process is also used for the production of wine and alcohol. Have you ever wondered why you get muscle cramps after heavy exercise? During heavy exercise or fast running, cycling, walking for many hours, the demand for the energy is high, but the supply of oxygen is limited. So our muscle cells also can perform anaerobic respiration only for a short period of time. So in that anaerobic respiration, inside our muscle cells, the glucose in the absence of oxygen break down to form lactic acid and energy. So in muscle cells, glucose break down to form lactic acid and energy in anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration means in the absence of oxygen. The accumulation of lactic acid causes muscle cramps. We get relief after a hot water bath or massage. It is because it will increase the circulation of blood to our muscle cells. So the muscle cells again break down to form carbon dioxide and water. Children, please read page numbers 108 and 109 of your textbook. I also attached a YouTube link to watch the animation of the topic. Download the notes and learn. Attend the test questions. See you in the next class with another topic. Till then, bye.